Elon Musk launched a car to Mars. Yeah, this happened. Yesterday at the office, we were all watching it live. It was pretty cool to witness. SpaceX officially made history yesterday when they successfully launched billionaire Elon Musk's electric Tesla Roadster into space on board the Falcon Heavy rocket. The Falcon Heavy took off from the Kennedy Space Center in Cape Canaveral, Florida, just after 3:45 p.m. EST. It was set to launch 3 hours earlier, but was delayed by high winds. The Falcon Heavy is a monumental long-distance rocket with an impressive array of 27 Merlin engines and 3 reusable Falcon 9 boosters. The rocket's cargo bay can carry up to 60 tons of material into low Earth orbit and up to 17 tons as far as Mars. Shortly after breaching the atmosphere, the Falcon 9 boosters touch back down to Earth to be repurposed in future missions. But this wasn't cheap. The Falcon Heavy launch cost $90 million, while NASA's planned SLS rocket is expected to cost around $1 billion per flight. Mr. Musk is a SpaceX founder and the mastermind behind the space mission. He's hopeful this voyage will pave the way for future manned missions to Mars. About this launch, Musk said, "I have this image of this giant explosion pad, with wheels bouncing down the road, and the logo landing somewhere with a thud. But fortunately, that's not what happened. Crazy things come true." The car is now speeding towards the red planet with David Bowie's hit song Space Oddity playing on loop, while a dummy in a spacesuit sits in the driver's seat. Before the stream cut out, the car was last seen on the live broadcast of the launch, flying over the breathtaking blue planet below. The projected path will bring the car close to Mars, where there is also a small chance it may crash into the planet. But if it stays on course, it will drift through space for potentially millions of years. The successful launch opens up a world of possibilities. There's talks of building a new space station above the moon, carrying new spy satellites, and shuttling people to deep space destinations. It's going to be interesting to see what comes of this over the next few years. Hey guys, and welcome back to LPM, Court McGinley. We are officially halfway through the week, and the weekend is right around the corner. I hope all of you are having a wonderful day so far. Now, I don't know where you all live, but I live in Toronto, Canada, and we got hit with a pretty bad snowstorm. So yeah, that sucks. I remember I used to love snow days like this when I was a kid, but now as an adult, it just means you're 2 hours late for work. Let me know where you're from and how the weather is down below. Also, make sure you stay tuned until the end of the video as I'll be answering some of your questions. And if you haven't asked a question yet, then make sure you leave one down in the comment section. Also, if you haven't yet subscribed to our channel, then what are you waiting for? Give that button a click and make sure you show some love by giving this video a big thumbs up. I mean, Valentine's Day is right around the corner, so showing love is important, you know? Alright, as you guys know, we have a lot of interesting news stories headed your way, so without further ado, let's get started. Next, 1,200 Olympic security guards have been quarantined after a norovirus outbreak. Jeez, I didn't even know the Olympics had so many security guards. So the Olympics is literally kicking off tomorrow, and now the organization committee have to deal with this. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention say that norovirus causes inflammation of the stomach or intestines or both. It results in diarrhea, vomiting, nausea, and stomach pain. It's a highly contagious bug. About this, the organization committee have said, "To address the shortfall in security workforce due to the isolation, 900 military personnel have been deployed to take over the work of the civil safety personnel. They will work across 20 venues until all affected workforce are able to return to duty. Surveys on tap water, the food preparation staff, and food items are currently being conducted to trace the route of the transmission." Also, unfortunately, the Olympics is the perfect place for an outbreak, and they most frequently happen in places like nursing homes, hospitals, prisons, colleges, and cruise ships, basically any environment that requires people to live and eat in close quarters. Precautionary measures are being taken, but hopefully they can find the cause before the games officially start. Next, the world's longest zipline is officially open to the public. A lot of people are super excited about this, but if you're not a big fan of heights, then the story might not be for you. But I mean, it's making history, so it's still pretty exciting, right? This zipline is referred to as the Jebel Jais flight. It's located in Dubai, and it runs from the top of the UAE's highest mountain. It's 1.7 miles long and reaches top speeds of 90 miles per hour. Previously, the longest zipline was known as the Green Monster, and it was 1.5 miles long. Now, aside from the zipline being a thrill-seeking adventure, it seems like just to get on the platform, it's quite a mission. The platform is suspended in the air. It's 9.5 tons and anchored by 8 anchors that are bolted into the sides of the mountain. I've been ziplining in Mexico and that was super fun, but that was nothing compared to this. Check it out.
not many people can say.
Next, I'm going to tell you guys about a very clever 9-year-old girl. So this 9-year-old is from San Diego and she's a Girl Scout. She somehow managed to sell 312 boxes of cookies in just 6 hours. How? Well, she set up a stand outside a marijuana dispensary. Well, it actually wasn't a stand, it was just basically her selling them out of her wagon, but you guys get the picture. The dispensary even advertised that this girl would be there, cookies in tow, to their clients over their Instagram page. So either this is a really business savvy 9-year-old, or it was just dumb luck. Either way, she sold an insane amount of cookies. I was a Girl Guide leader last year, and I can tell you, that's really impressive. Next, speaking of treats, all of you Kinder chocolate fans, get ready. Kinder Bueno ice cream is now a thing. Several versions of the ice cream are being released around the world and they look delicious. The release date is yet to be given, but it's probably going to be sometime in the summer. When it is released, we're going to be introduced to the Kinder ice cream sandwich, the Kinder ice cream stick, and the Kinder Bueno ice cream cone. Yeah, I think it's safe to say I'm most excited for that last one. Which one are you most eager to try? Let me know down in the comments. And it's that time of the week where I answer your guys' questions, so let's get started. Bethany Watson asked, would you rather kill a kid or divorce Landon? 100% divorce Landon. I would never kill a kid. Plus, you know, it helps that Landon and I aren't married. Next, Stephen Battle asked, would you ever be in any Jurassic Park movies? Yes. That would be amazing. My husband Liam, yes, not Landon, Liam, and I actually went to a ranch in Hawaii where they filmed parts of Jurassic Park. It was so cool and honestly such an unreal place. We got some amazing pictures. Zara Bulubtina, sorry if I said your name wrong, asked, have you ever thought of having kids? If yes, how many and what would their names be? Well, I know for sure we want 2 kids at least, but I'd be good with 3 or 4 as well. And I'm keeping the names to myself for now. Next, Jack Waldrop asked, what is your favorite candy? I think I'd have to go with Sour Patch Kids or Skittles. And there you guys have it. That's all the news stories I have for you today. Thank you guys so much for your questions. Make sure you leave some more down in the comment section for me to answer in tomorrow's video. And I'll see all of you tomorrow. Bye-bye.